This is a little segment I like to call Ham Begs for Cashews. Want a cashew? Want cashews? Give me your paw. Give me your paw. Give me your paw. Up. Oh, give me your paw. Give it your paw. Get it up. Get it up. I've been trying to get... The only thing I can get him is his drool. Give me your paw. You know what to do. Lift it up. Lift your paw up. There we go. There's always one fool who's gonna ask me what kind of cashews are you eating, Jordan? What kind of cashews are you eating, Jordan? Here, paw. Here, paw. Get it up. Get it up. Get it up. Get it up. Here, paw. Here, paw. Wanna jump for it? Wanna jump for it? Wanna jump for it? Yep. Wanna jump? Wanna jump for it? Wanna jump for it? Gonna jump for it? Jump, jump, jump. Jump for it? He likes green beans so much. He would jump for the green beans, not for the cashews. I'd like to have Queen Bee Knightley over here and make her jump for her food.
Yes!
Come on over, baby, we can shake. Shake, shake. Hear that, Janine? Come on over, baby. We can shake, shake, shake. I'm making a magical potion. I'm going to drink it. It's a combination of soda light, pink rose quartz, and
Almarazite, and it's
going to give me the ability to kill Gilbert and JSX without even touching them. It's going to allow me to explode both of their brains from the inside out. I forgot what those two on the here on the right are.
I just remember this one allowed me to remember my past life.
And I forgot what the other one is. Can't remember all this crap.
I look like Wesley from Princess Bride. If only I had a mustache. So anyway, why am I dead inside? If it all fails, says that I sound like a dying cow. And Commander Thor says that I'm not funny anymore. There's a lot of reasons why I'm not funny anymore, just because I'm dead inside, and too many times there's been times where people have gotten my hopes up, and it's always been destroyed. And, plus whole being so unloved thing, and plus watching all of the people like 13 Sign Astrology, JSX, and everyone else get so much love, but I tell more truth than any of them, and I get all the hate, and relatively no subscribers, so... Yeah, that wears on you, and it ages you. Plus, when they cloned me, that took a lot out, too, because when they clone you, it's like having kids where you participate in the fractal universe. Fractal meaning that I've been divided. Eternal deadness is like eternal deadness. Eventually, on a long enough timeline, you wind up like Alan Watts, who has no serotonin. When I laugh, it's very hard to see. It's hard to remember last time I laughed. So I was at the organic store. And I was talking to the guy who was making my smoothie in that one video. And he was telling me how he gets laid a lot because he plays guitar in front of people, where others consume alcohol in public. I said, damn, I gotta put the dumbbell down and fucking pick up the guitar. I'm still sick. As you can tell. I think it's because I've been spending too much time in the Chateau de Amarat, the castle of the Dark Mother. That's my home away from home.
And is it just me, or does it seem like every time you watch a JSX video and he's talking about pedophilia and he starts doing that, like, it sounds like he pretends to be angry about it. Now, I know if you become energy sensitive, you can feel it, but with him, it just seems like he's acting. So he'll say something to the effect of, "Man, that's some sick shit. No, that's some sick crap. I disagree with that. I disagree with that." It just seems like he's overacting it. And you figure a man like him hasn't seen vagina and raccoon's aid. You know, that's what I'm wondering. Where is his wife in all this? Seems like she's very secretive about everything. He's hiding everything. He's like, where's his wife? Where's his children? Where is this? Where is that? Where is it? And you can tell he's like a... Oh my god, this guy. This fucking guy. I got a feeling we'll never hear a word out of his mouth. A word like Netaru. You'll never hear that. You'll never hear that out of his mouth. I'm really getting sick of this guy already. This guy has to go because doesn't even bring anything to YouTube. I want to read this guy's like tax returns. I'm dying to read this guy's tax returns, and I want him to open his books, and I want to get all up in his business. I want to look at this open awareness business. I want to see what all of this is about. I'm so pretty and witty and not gay. And I pity any Neanderthal who isn't me today. La 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 la. See, I'm entertaining. Oh, by the way, Captain Kitty Bum Report, you're going to be cooking my breakfast. I want 2 grilled chicken breasts, 3 egg whites with real organic eggs, and a multigrain bagel, dry, toasted, with organic jelly. You will cook my breakfast, and you will lay down for me, because you are a soulless, worthless, Rothschild, Pleiadian female, who's only good for what's between her legs, and what she can cook on a grill. I know I'm coming to you more sooner than later. Anybody start to notice that Graveyard Girl is the same type of fae alien as Sarah Adams, because they both have that, like, goofy top lip that does that. They're both Tinkerbells. And Faye usually have the vision, and Graveyard Girl has had a lot of paranormal experiences. And I bet you if she were to eat vegan and stop eating That girl drinks fucking soda all the time and eats bacon. And she is so much like Sarah Adams. Because they're both petite. They both have the same top lip. So, yeah. So, Commander Thor says that J.B. Murdoch is the queen of all ascending reptilians. Does that make her and I soulmates? Come on over, baby. We can shake, shake, shake.